Hello and welcome student to our TYBSC class. Today in this video we are going to discuss our next chapter, that is sources and types of GIS data. In this chapter, first of all we are going to discuss about data sources. Data sources, there are mainly four types of data sources which we are using as a GIS data, that is topo sheet, surveying data, data collected with the help of aerial photography, that is aerial photographs, as well as data collected by satellite in the form of satellite images. Apart from that, in this chapter we are also going to discuss about data types, mainly spatial data types and non-spatial data types. So first we are going to talk about data sources. Topo sheet, as we all know that topo sheet, the Survey of India, they provide us topo sheet. Nowadays it is available online also. If we go to the Nakshe website of Government of India, we can download the topo sheet by providing our Aadhaar number. In topo sheet we are getting both physical information as well as cultural information of any area, and the entire India is covered by topo sheet. So if we want to collect the information about any village level information, for example the cultural as well as physical information of a small area, we are getting the detailed information from the topo sheet, and this information, this topo sheet can be scanned and used in the GIS software, and we can extract the information and convert it into the digital format also, that we can use in the form of point line or polygon features. So all the information, whether it is physical or cultural, it is all present in topo sheet. So it is one of the very important data sources of GIS. The next data sources is surveying. Primary information is collected with the help of questionnaire which we prepare while doing the survey, as well as with the help of total station, dumpy level, theodolite, we also collect the elevation data as well as the physiographical information of the region, and this information plays a very handy role as a GIS data for the purpose of research and map making. The next information, the next data source is aerial photograph. As we all know that with the help of platform, that is aircraft, balloon, we can collect the information by using camera or a sensor by taking the photograph from the top, and this information is referred as aerial photographs. So with the help of aerial photography we can collect the information of a region and make a aerial photographs, and these aerial photographs can be utilized as a data sources in GIS for extracting or studying various objects, various features of a region. With the help of this aerial photographs we can also identify the change detection by taking the photograph of the same region from time to time and observing the various change in the patterns or what change has occurred. The next important data source is satellite data. As we know that the ISRO, that is Indian Space Research Organization, they have launched various satellites from 1972 up to December 2019. They have launched around hundreds of satellites. So these satellites, they are providing various information related to climate, disaster management, environment, as well as earth observation. So with the help of this satellite, huge amount of information is collected about the earth, and this information is present in the form of satellite images. So satellite images can be a very handy tool and a huge data source for GIS. So student, these four data sources are the important data sources in GIS: topo sheets, surveying information, aerial photographs, satellite data, that is satellite images. Now we will be talking about data types. Mainly there are two types of data, one is spatial data and another one is non-spatial data. So spatial data, it is any information about the location and shape of geographic features and their relationship. Spatial data include remotely sensed data as well as map data. Spatial data is that data which has physical dimension and geographic location on the earth. The data is available in the form of map. Spatial data stored in a map can be described by three concepts, that is entity, attributes and relations. So by the definition, entity is a distinct spatial object, while relationship is the spatial association among entities. I repeat again, entity is a distinct spatial object, while relationship is the spatial association among entities. For example, river is an entity, while its connection with other water body is relation. The relation represents linked between two different entities. In general, spatial data on a map can be described as unstructured representation of point, line and area object. Talking about point, point feature are a spatial phenomena, each of which occurs at only one location in space. For example, trees, house, road, intersection, etc. Each features is said to be discrete because it occupies only a given point in a space at any time. For the conceptual modeling, these objects are assumed to have no spatial dimension, although each can be referenced by its location coordinates. Points are said to have zero dimension. In reality, all points object have some spatial dimension, however, we are not able to observe them in the first place. The spatial scale at which we observe this object are feature place, a framework on which we can determine whether we should think of them as a points. For example, if one is looking at a house from few meters away from the structure occupies a sustainable amount of length and width. However, as one moves away from the house, it appears less like an object and more like a point object. So, a spatial scale is determined on the basis of different criterion. Talking about line. Line is the simplest one-dimensional object. It is straight line between two points determined by the sequence of point at which the path changes direction. This one-dimensional object that is fundamentally long, the scale of which is above this object, once again place a fundamental limitation to our ability. Unlike the point object, linear object allows us to measure their spatial extent by simply finding out how long they are, that we must know at least two points, that is a beginning and ending points. The more complex the line, more points we will need to indicate exactly where the line is located. For example, if we take a stream, the description of which may require large number of points to define the two twists and the turns of that features. Talking about area, the object observed closely into A clearly seen to occupy both length and width are called area. They are two-dimensional object. The description of area itself is normally based on geometry of bounding line segment. For example, an aerial of a city, continent, forest, etc. Surface. Surface or volume object have length, breadth or height or depth. Therefore, surface is a 3D object. Surface occur all around us as a natural features. For example, hills, valleys, ridges, cliff. Surface features are composed of an infinite number of possible height values. Surface feature is said to be a continuous because the possible values of height are distributed without interruption continuously across the surface. So student, this was about the special feature. The entities are point, line, area and surface. So a feature. Now we will talk about special relationship, functional relationship and logical relationship. Spatial relationship are the association for the connection between different real world features. Such relationship can be geometric when adjacent feature share same boundary. They can also be proximal when one feature is said to be close to another feature. Geometric spatial relationship explains the absolute and the relative location. Absolute position on the earth are recorded relative to the location of celestial bodies such as North Star. Absolute location and relative location are useful in spatial analysis and in many GIS application. Distance between the features, the proximity of the features and the neighborhood of the feature are those spatial relationship which are important in many GIS analysis. For example, network analysis, it makes the use of spatial relationship between the line segments in the vector data to determine the shortest route between the two points, direction and the movement from one place to another. This kind of spatial relationship are used in migration studies. The direction of the relationship is used in hydrologic modeling to determine the direction of slope and the areas affected by a point source in environmental pollution investigation. The from node and to node are the typical example of spatial relationship in database. The relationship are also being computed when the data are used to determine the intersection of two lines. Containment of one polygon inside the other and the position of point relative to point geometric spatial relationship such as and at is within, intersect, overlap are relatively easy to determine with it. It is difficult to quantify a symmetric relationship such as near to or not away from, as the different people have different ideas about what is meant by near and not far away. So this was about the spatial relationship. Now let us see what is functional relationship. Functional relationship includes how two features are connected and how they intersect or interact in real life. For example, road network might be classified functionally from the national highway to the most isolated rural road based upon their role in the overall transportation system. Minor roads and suburban street feed major highway but are not directly connected to them. In assessing wildlife habitat, various environmental conditions function together to define the optimum living environment for a certain species. Then, within cities, ownership is a functional classification which is of great importance in determining the zones. So, this was about functional relationship. Logical relationship, it involves if, then, and, or conditions. Means, as we have studied in, I think so, in statistics, conditions such as if, then, or, nor, XOR, such conditions are used in logical relationship. This condition must exist among features stored in the data set. For example, no land may be permitted to be a zone for a residential use if it is lies within a river's 5-year flood plain. So this is the condition. No land can be used as a residential zone if it is lying in the floodplain region of river for 5 years. So 5 years is the condition, floodplain is the condition, then residential zone is the condition. So based on this 3 data set, we will be getting the response from the data set with the help of GIS software, that which area should be suitable for a residential zone and which area is not suitable for the residential zone. Now let us see a types of spatial relation. It refers to the closeness features may have association as they are spatially near to each other following a spatial relationship are used in the query analysis. So first type of spatial relationship is containment. Containment are completely within. It selects feature that fall for completely within the features. For example, finding school within a selected area. For example, if you are interested in the school data within a specific area, that is called a containment relationship. Second one is intersection. It selects the features that intersect given features. For example, selecting a land areas that intersect a proposed road and finding the urban areas that interact an active fault line. Next one is proximity. Proximity, it selects the features that are within the specified distance of a features for selection. It shows the association and it means closeness. For example, finding park within a mile of a selected street. For example, if you are living in a particular area and you are interested in finding out the park within 1 kilometer. So 1 kilometer is the distance range from your location. So this distance range which you have providing is referred as proximity. The common proximity characteristics are connectivity, adjacency, and connectivity and continuity, sorry, the degree of connectivity. If the distance between a specific feature is 0, then proximity becomes adjacency. For example, selecting land area that are adjacent to a flood zone or findings. For example, area within the distance of say XYZ, or share a line segment with, for example, touch the boundary of, are identical to. So these are the conditions of proximity. Such statements are used to show the spatial relationship. Spatial relationship are also explained with first distance. It is an elementary but important relationship it is available through a simple measurement. Second distribution, it is collective location of factor or a geographical disposal of features. There are two basic ways of distribution. Features among themselves, their relationship with other features, or say density, it is the number of items per unit area. It explains how close features are to each other. And fourth one is the pattern. It is a consistent arrangement of features similar to distribution and density. So these are the types of spatial relationship: containment, intersection, and proximity. So this was all about spatial. Now we are going to discuss non-spatial data, or it is commonly referred as attribute data also. Non-spatial data, it is a description of geographical features in the form of number, character, typically stored in table or linked to the graphic of the features by common identity. Attributes are descriptive information about specified spatial data or where the things are. This is the example, or where the things are. Attribute data are what the things are. So where, what, such questions are present. It means attribute data attacks the quality to the spatial data. It describes some aspect of the spatial data. Attribute data keeps on changing as per the requirement. See student, as attribute data is the description of the spatial data. For example, if you are having any spatial data and you are providing information about the spatial data, or you are adding additional information about that spatial data, so the additional information is referred as non-spatial data. Types of attribute data are nominal data, ordinary data, interval data, ratio, direction, or cyclic data. So let us see one by one. First, nominal data. It is the simplest types of attribute data. It serves only to identify or distinguish one entity to other. It provides only qualitative difference. There is no ranking, and the data are classified without hierarchy. For example, place, name, or number. These data serve only to identify the particular of a class or entities from other members of the same class. Nominal attributes includes number of letters and even colors. If the nominal attribute is numeric, it makes number sense to apply the arithmetic operations. Ordinary data, attributes are ordinal if their values have a natural order. For example, class representing high density, low density in a particular area. It is a quantitative data that provide the map user with information about differences in the rank or hierarchy, but not about their class or amount. So ordinal data provide the hierarchical information, provides the information related to the ranking of the data. Interval data, attributes have natural sequence, but in addition, the distance between values have meaning. For example, the scale of Celsius, temperature in Celsius, to say that 30 and 20 are different as 20 and 10. So interval data, it is the two data does not have the arithmetic difference, but their differences have some senses. The next data type is ratio data type. Attributes have some characteristics as interval variables, but in addition, these have zero or a starting point. Example, rainfall per month. Weight is a ratio because it makes sense to say that a person of 100 kg is twice as heavy as a person of 50 kg. But Celsius temperature is only interval, because 20 degree Celsius is not twice as 10 degree Celsius. This is very important. This argument applies to all scales that are based on similarly arbitrary zero points, including longitudes. So this is the difference between interval data and ratio data. Now last one is directional or a cyclic data. In GIS, it is sometimes necessary to deal with data that can be directional or cyclic, including the flow direction on map or a compass direction or a longitudes. The special problem here is that the number following 359 is zero, talking about longitudes. Averaging the direction such as 359 and 1 yields the average of two directions close to north can appear to be south.